Last time,
on Cruising Joan Lynn,
we depart the port of Oswego and cruise up the Oswego River to Oneida Lake.
And we are off.
We make the 22-mile crossing to the east end of Oneida Lake and land at the Snug Harbor Marina.
And oh my God, what a fiasco.
Cindy, which one's Cindy?
They're both Cindy's.
Oh, all right, easy.
We are about to take a walk through a ranger tug.
They really
see the bathroom? Back to our stupid boat.
Oh my God, our boat sucks.
We spend the weekend with new friends along the beachfront while cruising across New York State along the Erie Canal. This episode of Cruising Joan Lynn.
Let's begin now.
I woke up this morning and I said, you know, instead of waiting for a good day to happen, you know, waiting around through ups and downs, you know, I just said, look.
On our first morning at the Snug Harbor Marina, located along the Erie Canal at Oneida Lake, we met our neighbors who gave us a tour of their brand new Ranger tug.
We are about to take a walk through a, what
kind of boat is it?
This is a Ranger tug.
A Ranger tug. It looks to me like a fancy Sidori, but I fell in love with it this morning when I took notice of it. And it's just a really, really clean boat. So we're about to have a tour. Ready?
Can you see up here? It's a flip.
Oh, yeah, I see that, yeah.
Back, I have the cushions inside.
Nice. I love this. I mean, the detail on this boat is amazing. I noticed on the other side, it was red and green.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's, I love the detail. And this, I mean, this is beautiful. This
it keeps the sun out.
Yeah.
This is our little refrigerator here.
The Donalee's aft deck features comfortable seating for four, an outdoor refrigerator, and an integrated freshwater sink and electric grill.
The back side of it, there's a shower, if you want a shower.
Below the aft deck houses a Westerbeek generator capable of running all of the Donalee's AC needs.
It handles everything the boat has.
So nice, oh my God.
It's got a nice little stove, oven.
The galley is equipped with a second refrigerator, an integrated microwave oven, and offers extra counter space when a portside chair is folded away. The Donalee's dinette transforms into different seating arrangements to include a bed, helmsman bench seat.
And you roll it back.
Okay. Yeah. That is so cool.
And an aft-facing seat with a bonus.
This opens up.
This is gonna be our next boat.
Huh?
I can tell this is gonna be our next boat.
Yeah, you could tell that things were thought out extremely carefully. When
they really.
Did you see the bathroom?
No, I didn't see
the bathroom. The bathroom is beautiful.
Below deck, the Donalee offers a roomy forward berth, complete with a TV and adequate closet space.
There's a lot of nice lighting too. You have a lot of
lighting.
Oh yeah, the trailer.
Put you in the mood there, huh?
The head compartment offers plenty of storage space, towel racks and hardware, and full shower capabilities.
This is such a cool boat.
The lavish helm station is equipped with all the electronic toys, a Garmin chart plotter, outboard engine monitoring system, bow thruster control, and autopilot to name a few.
This is your autopilot.
Autopilot, that's
something. Yeah, this is would be, but it's gonna be shut off unless I turn the motor off.
And how does this hull design handle, have you had it out in the Great Lakes at all,
no,
Lake Ontario?
No, I haven't, but I have it on Lake Ontario. Yeah, it handles pretty good.
Does it?
Yeah, it does.
Huh. And in your average Lake Ontario, when you're obviously not going to go on crazy weather, but your average 2 foot waves.
Oh yeah, it handles them pretty good.
3 foot swells.
Yeah.
And you can actually, so you said you can actually get this boat up to planing speed.
We run it, we try to use the economical miles per hour. At 23 miles an hour, it'll get 2 miles to the gallon, which isn't bad. You can look at the headroom.
The skylights that open up.
These open up.
So nice. Ugh, I'm so jealous. Ugh.
And then, of course, there is, I don't know who would use it. Of course, I can't. That's a little berth too, you know.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but we just use it for storage.
Oh, yeah.
It does go way up in here, but I mean, a little kid could use it.
Yeah.
Well, but storage.
Yeah, we just use it for storage.
Yeah.
I mean, I think to do what we've been doing is like living on it, you know? I mean, it's a nice boat to kind of go, but this is really, you could really live on this.
Yeah, her and I could definitely.
You could.
Joan and I began drooling over this beautiful boat and had to excuse ourselves after the tour, but not before noticing Jim and Donna's ice maker. But more on that later.
Back to our stupid boat.
Oh my God, our boat sucks. I want one of those.
After the tour, we called for an Uber service to pick us up and take us to the store to provision the boat.
And we're waiting for our Uber ride.
For ice maker.
Yeah, after that tour, we were convinced that an ice maker might be a good option if we could find one at Walmart. It'll pay itself off. The amount of ice that we buy from Marina is at $4 or $5 a bag. Our Uber ride has arrived, and I think it's the Uber car. I don't know, it's hard to tell. You're the Uber driver, right?
Uber and Lyft services are convenient and affordable ways for cruisers to get from places beyond walking distance from transient dockage.
Fireworks.
However, not every town has the services available, and it's a good idea to check and have a plan B in mind. Joan found an ice maker and appliances while I shopped around for dinner ingredients.
Well, we have the ingredients for a nice dinner tonight.
And Joan found some more boat clutter.
Forks and knives, yeah.
Things were going well until after we checked out and were trying to get an Uber ride back to the marina.
Uber is giving us a problem here.
We both got at our Uber apps and we both had a different ride and his is close by, but the car keeps spinning, so we don't know if it's going our direction or the other direction.
I think the Uber driver is almost here. That was kind of a cluster. It took about 20 minutes. We're looking for a silver BMW.
Uber finally shows up to our relief, and we make our way back to the marina with dinner and a new ice maker.
On the way back to the marina.
Plug in our new ice maker.
New ice maker.
Our slow progression to becoming more like Jim and Donna.
Yeah.
With much haste, we scrambled to make and eat dinner because we look forward to the promise of an evening cruise up the canal with Jim and Donna aboard the Donalee.
We are about to head out on the Donalee to watch the sunset. So say goodbye to Joan Lynn for a while.
One of the things we wanted to mention about our stay in this area was the infestation of an insect that we learned later to be mayflies. They were everywhere, covering boats and other areas where lights were kept on at night. Piles of dead mayflies were being shoveled into buckets at the marina each day. We learned later that mayflies are aquatic insects with very short adult lifespans. As a population, they mature all at once and fly in swarms feeding on algae and diatoms. The presence of mayflies is a sign of a healthy ecosystem, as mayflies have low tolerances to pollution and other man-made influences on the environment. Fish and other wildlife rely on them as sources of food, and the mayfly serves to redistribute nutrients to the ecosystem.
I am cheating on my boat right now because I was just invited to captain this ranger that we took a tour through earlier today, and it is a smooth riding boat. I gotta tell you, perfect album.
We landed the Donalee back at the marina at dusk And do you remember the wine we bought in Oswego in episode 2? Gone in less than 20 minutes, while the four of us shared our boating adventures and got to know each other under the starry skies of that evening in late June.
All right, good night. Bye. Thank you. It's our third morning, which is now afternoon actually, at the Snug Harbor Marina. We decided to stay an extra night because of a few things. Number one is we got lazy. Number two, we wanted to maybe spend an extra day with some friends that we met here, that you met yesterday. And number three, the wind. It's a nice day out. It rained overnight, but the wind today is a bit much, 15 to 18 miles an hour, and the lake, Oneida Lake, is a very shallow lake, and it doesn't take much for that lake to kick up. There's probably 4-foot waves out there, and if we have to cross the whole entire thing, we'd rather do it tomorrow, so.
Now,
there you go.
We can go. This ice cream guy over here, it's $1 million for an ice cream. So we go up the top of the hill of White Hills and get whatever you like. Yeah. And it's Perry, it's good ice cream.
Sure. We are at the White Hill Express having some ice cream, courtesy of Jim. Thanks, Jim, by the way. Donna, she doesn't want any ice cream. She'd rather have a salad.
After Jim took care of some personal business, the four of us took a walk down the windy beach to Harpoon Eddie's for some drinks.
We're having a good time with good friends.
No, I just think you should slow down. This is what, your third water?
After a few drinks, Jim led us outside where the real party was taking place. Way through the amusement park, temptation overwhelmed us to buy tickets to the world's craziest ride.
All right, so Donna,
yes.
We're standing outside what they call the world's craziest ride. We're about to find out if it holds up to the name.
Yes.
Right? The world's craziest ride. And I see on the outside of it, it looks like we get into a cart and drive around on the inside, but yep. We don't know what to expect.
No, they said you'll laugh, you'll scream, you'll howl, and you'll howl.
All right, so and we have to do all those things, otherwise this is false advertising. All right, it's freaking me out a little bit. Can't see a damn thing right now. I can't see anything. It's just dark. I can't see anything. It's just... Ah, there's a skeleton! Oh, the battery ran out.
What did you do?
It was crazy. That's a good.
And did you do something besides laugh?
I screamed
you
a little.
Crazy or laugh?
That was freaking crazy. The craziest thing I've ever done today, I'll tell you that.
Crazy clam.
Right now we're at the crazy clam with good friends, and we're enjoying the weekend.
We are going to try fried macaroni and cheese. This is a plate of pure, healthful goodness.
Delicious.
Good.
Who would think this is excellent?
After dinner, we made our way back to the marina, and before hunkering down for the night, we paid a visit to the slip of one of our followers who was out of town this particular weekend but sent us a Facebook message wishing us well.
We just want to give a shout out to Barry Rivet.
Hi, Barry.
Sorry we missed you. Maybe next time.
Learned of love. Tucked away in the cabin of our boat, we knew that tomorrow would mean moving on. But among the things we would take with us, would be the memories of the weekend we spent with Jim and Donna in the summer of 2019.
Now that the spring is in the air, pretty girls are everywhere. Think of me and I'll be there. Starfish on the beach. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun. But the stars we could reach were just starfish on the beach. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun. But the wine and the song, like the seasons have all gone. All our lives we had fun, we had seasons in the sun.
Next time.
I'm cruising Joan Lynn. As hard as it was to do, we say our goodbyes to Snug Harbor Marina and set course across Oneida Lake to the Erie Canal in hopes to reach Baldwinsville by mid-afternoon.
All right, we're about two-thirds of the way across Oneida Lake. Probably about 2 to 3 foot chop.
We're approaching an area of the Erie Canal called the Three Rivers.
We got 20 miles on the Erie Canal before we hit our destination.
This is like 24.
Lot 24, just wondering what the ETA is for westbound traffic. What are we having for lunch?
Sandwich, turkey sandwich.
My wife makes the best turkey sandwiches ever.
Baldwinsville.
Well, we reached Baldwinsville, but we got some bad news.
Waiting on our laundry. Fun time.
Well, today we'll be going through the Montezuma Wildlife Refuge.